taking pictures overseas, money hitting my account. Old schools tucked away, might be time to bring them out. Been taking in the cut with the touchscreen, ooh, I might take a drive to Monterey to go and cool out. I got old money for real, and some new guap. I had to separate from a few, they moving too hot. So much money on my schedule, I ain't got time. Out in Detroit, eating fruit with a top model. Coupe, no rims, we some gentlemen. We got many M's, don't belittle him.
I talk a lot, Joe. By your sweet Princess Ilka.
I got different businesses. I did it all, no assists. Who went hard like this? I went to Rory, drop six, nigga. I paid cash for the, got the D for the. You just thought I had, come on. You know I'm smarter than that. I hit the booth and then I slaughtered the track. You niggas gotta relax. Look, I do this shit in my sleep. It's just normal. You can keep the receipts, my nigga. Sad.
Ciao. Let's talk about something else, not about the shits around. Let's just distract and deviate from the eternal present. I told you this morning I went to Cuernavaca one last time and to Tepoztlan to deposit Yaki's aunt at an old folks home. Well, she was in one in Cuernavaca, and Yaki had the feeling, the image, that he was being cheated upon. I think, dicho y hecho, absolutely true. So the aim was to take her out of Cuernavaca and bring her to a different facility in Tepoztlan, which I did. I don't know who suggested it, but I was quite impressed. It was like, oh my God, I have not seen one luxurious resort on earth with such wide, green lawn. Vast, rich. At the side, there was like, I don't know, tiny houses or bungalows or enough space for the old people actually wait for the death man. It's kind of gruesome to think about it, if you think about it. No, she was like mentally already gone. And so was someone else I met there. And I don't know about the rest, but these are many people were like, yeah, in the last breath. I think they were like shuffled around in wheelchairs, which of course in Mexican community idea, they had like meetings. Or let's say when they were out of their beds in their rooms, they would be pushed and put in, yeah, not maybe not only wheelchairs, I'm not quite sure, or maybe also in chairs. But each by a nurse and into the garden, and they would be accommodated in a circle. So they would all sit around in a circle, yeah, and the nurses around. So as I arrived and brought, yeah, his aunt over there, now she was absolutely unconscious. Oh, well, she looked, she ate and stuff, but she was absolutely unavailable. Oh, I don't even know how that worked, because I personally did not transport her. I just arranged kind of paperwork. So in that new facility, all in circles, and so I sat there with them and looked at that scene. It was quite, I don't know, it was strange. Because the owner, I wondered, well, how can he afford that? How can he afford this property? But he got it from, is it an inheritance? Did he settle? But he seemed so smeary to me. His skin was all like gray and greasy and mistreated, I think. I don't recall his face. He wasn't old. He was maybe 40 or a little bit older, 45. Maybe older, I don't know. Yeah, that is the guy which much later, when I had called once, they left me hanging on the phone in the office. I don't know for what reason I had to call. Yeah, from San Francisco to Mexico. And I heard him, because they left the phone on the table. I heard him, Jesus talking people, admonishing them about Jesus and the Bible. No, I literally, that was under my tray already. I literally hang in there for like 35 minutes. I just had to corroborate that he was such a shit. Because those people who admonish, they have it filthy, but everywhere. The bill which came from aunt, her medicine, I don't know, she took like 237 medicines. That made no sense. Man, did they overcharged. What do? You sit in a different country. Sneaky, sneaky. I will go over to the recital in just a moment. Yeah, I think about the entire thing. I mean, the facilities were gorgeous. I don't remember if you can... In theory, yes, you could see the Tepozteco. I mean, beautiful. And enough personnel to attend all the people. And yet dignified, I guess, for their last breath. No, she passed there. She died there. I don't know how shortly after. I don't remember. A year later? I don't think she made it to 2. Because she was ill. I will tell you this as I often think about things. Now I'm gonna like think as I speak. I think about a lot of where illnesses hence come from, because I think they are psychological enhanced. And Jaiki's father prided himself of being super mega intelligent, and his sister, which was Jaiki's aunt, that particular aunt, did the same. I think she was a school teacher in San Francisco before she moved to Cuernavaca. Priding themselves of intelligence is not really intelligent. Yeah, I say I'm intelligent, but that's all because I have to. But otherwise, why would I say it? It's a different angle. Because perhaps in my case, it is. I'm not priding myself because you can't see me. So who am I going to pride about? You cannot see the intelligence I have. But it is maybe the opposite way. It is excusatory for you. Just not to be that smart. It's okay to make mistakes. It's okay to learn things. It's okay to take a while. It's okay. It's okay. It's the okay scenario. Let's go back. So why did the intelligent woman who prided herself, just like her brother, of being so very, very intelligent, why did she lose her memory, man? See what I mean? I question things and I doubt things, because that's what happened. Like President Reagan. No, it's called Alzheimer's. It's quite gruesome, because eventually it's gruesome how they die. I did not say it. But I met someone else over there who I think had a really hard life next to Almut, and that was Aureliano. Unexpected, as we were sitting in circle, I look and there he was, just another patient. Alzheimer's too, I was told. He next to Almut, yeah, Pura Lopez said it. Wow, Almut, the quack, quack, quack. Oh my God, she was just a nutcase. Yeah, the couple who kind of adopted me when I arrived in Cuernavaca. Because when I had my, you know, when I fell down the stairs and, I said broke my ankle, but I didn't broke the entire thing. They came to rescue me and bring me to the doctor. So here was Aureliano now sitting, and he had really hard times to finish up the house. He built a really nice house for his wife and his son. A nice house for simple people, but a good house. He architect, he traveled a lot for work because he couldn't find a job in Cuernavaca. Yeah, he often brought me cafe from Chiapas because he went all the way to Chiapas to fulfill some job. Yeah, and he sat on my kitchen table and, I don't know, in his world maybe he poured his heart out. Because he acknowledged a few things, particularly the money and other things, and the worry, but he was very calm and very composed, so I did never heard him worried. He smiled a lot, but he was worried. And I think there was like a lot of pressure during a lot of many years. And then, you know, his wife went ill too. I don't know what she had, but then she was like, oh, she needed a lot of aid. Something which damaged her partial, I don't know, mentally she was disturbed, being part of the egotistical Walter Reuter wannabe photographer who also stole the artwork and made himself a photographer, although he never was, and claimed fame and stardom his entire life. Yeah, and left his daughter, both of the daughters, the first from his first marriage, Yeah, hecho pedazos, man. Left in, how do you say it, shackles? Yeah, Amon was deprived of love. Poof. And Aureliano, like Buddha said, is a saint, so he's sticking it out. But here he was now. He did have the house, he built the house, and yeah, he put his son through a university too. Man, I think he studied the same as I in my university. Did I saw him once? No, I had no contact with him. Some spoiled brat, man. That's how he turned out. By giving him everything out of the sacrifice of his father, I think he turned out a real shit. Different from another guy I met, and that was another, okay, that was a cousin from my brother Raul, who had a language school in Cuernavaca. And she had a son, and they looked like. It's like, if I would meet them on the street, I would not recognize who's who. Yeah, I had to feel into their integration and their vibration. And she had an English, a Spanish school to look for foreigners. And her son, yeah, I don't know, he was 20-something, helped her. He was actually, maybe he was manager of something. So he had responsibilities. And to me, they have the same age, and they have like the same outlook, and all the same, these two. Yeah, Almud and Aureliano's son, and then this Lara is her name, Raoul's cousin. No, she was a little older. She was alone with her son. But since this son of her in the school had so much responsibilities, he turned out a good guy, man. Semi-good guy, I think. No, he looked more like he understood the meaning of life and what work means and responsibilities and tasks and timelines and all that. I noticed this. No, I did not. I saw her a few times and he was there too, coming in and out in her house maybe. And so I noticed these things real quick, the way they relate, right? Because the ignorant students, the brats, they're just shits, man. They don't take into account anything and anybody. But the moment people suffer, they see the world from a different angle. So Aureliano, well, he suffered a little bit too much. He got himself an Alzheimer, and I think just because it was too much to handle. That was my conclusion.
All's my life I has to fight. All's my life I... Hard times like, yeah. Bad trips like, yeah. Nazareth, I'm f***ed up, homie, you f***ed up. But if God got us, then we gon' be alright.
We gon' be alright. We gon' be alright. We gon' be alright. Do you hear me? Do you feel me? We gon' be alright. We gon' be alright.
And when I wake up, I recognize you looking at me for the pay cut. Bahamas, I be looking at you from the face down. One Mac 11, even room with the bass down. Skimming, and let me tell you about my life. Painkillers only put me in a twilight. We're pretty Benjamin is the highlight. Now tell my mama I love her, but this what I like. Lord knows, 20 of them in my Chevy. Tell them all to come and get me, reaping everything I sow. So my karma come in heaven, no preliminary.